I did my presentation on phylum Xenocoelomorpha. Xenocoelomorpha has been placed in many spots in the phylogenetic tree due to their bilateral symmetry, but also their primitive characteristics, being that they lack certain features that include cephalization, complete digestive system with excretory cells, conclude that they are primitive. Much of their phylogeny is still uncertain, but as of now, they are sister group to the Protostomia and Deuterostomia. They are a large center of interest due to their primitive nature, because they are important for studying bilateral evolution. Some of their primitive characteristics, like a single gut opening, they share with cnidarians, but they do still have more derived characteristics like bilateral symmetry, a mesoderm, and various musculature development that show that they're more derived than cnidarians. This is an example of a current phylogeny tree that we have at the moment. So we have our cnidarians with radial symmetry, but they do share nerve net and sac-like gut with the Xenocoelomorpha, shown here, and then as we go on to more derived characteristics, we have the Protostoma and Deuterostoma. Some general characteristics of this phylum overall are going to be they are mostly soft-bodied marine worms with direct development. They have no body cavity. They have circular and longitudinal muscles, Hox genes, anterior statuses. They do have ciliated bodies on the outside, all along their epidermal layer, them move and swim. They do lack distinct organs, excretory system, and a developed nerve system, but they do have a primitive nerve system, which is going to be a nerve net with various degrees of cephalization, and they go through reproduction either through sexual or asexual. They release gametes through their mouth or body rupture. Three clades in the phylum Xenocoelomorpha are going to be Acoel, which is an egg, the Myrtodermatia, which is going to be example B, and Xenoturbellidia, which is going to be example C. For subphylum Acoelomorpha, this is going to contain two classes, Acoel and the Myrtodermatia, which is going to make up about 398 species of the phylum. And they are distinctive in the subphylum by their postulate bodies, which are old epidermal cells that are going to be withdrawn from the epidermis to the digestive tissue for resorption. And they also have unique musculature properties like orthogonal and ventral diagonal muscular grids, which are very distinctive to this class. And they also have a primitive brain, which is going to be a cerebral ganglion, which is still primitive but derived or more advanced for this phylum itself. And they are originally included in phylum Platyhelminthes. For class Acoel specifically, they're going to have a lifestyle that's either found on sediment, rock, algae, or cnidarians, or they could be sediment dwellers in brackish waters. They range from size 1 millimeter to about 5 meters, and their shape is going to vary based on their lifestyle. If they're interestial, they're going to be more long and slender, and if they're swimming, they're going to be more cylindrical with tapered ends. They also have predatory behaviors due to large species feeding on mollusks or other worms, and small species feeding on protists like diatoms. They feed through their cinctum that's going to phagocytize ingested food, and some even have photosynthetic endosymbionts, which have been identified as either zooxanthellae or zooxanthellae. Their nervous system is going to be more advanced for this phylum, but still primitive, because it's various paired longitudinal nerve cords with sensory cells, but no actual brain. It's going to create like a primitive brain. They do have simple light sensors, or ocelli. They have direct development in a form of spiral cleavage, and their reproduction is through asexual or sexual reproduction. They do have three types of asexual reproduction they can go through, which is longitudinal fission, transverse fission, or budding. And they also have a distinctive multipotent cells. Multipotent cells, which are going to be mesodermally derived from the neoblasts. Acoels are also distinctive for their pigments. It's not completely known why they have differenti- polymorphic pigments on them, but three hypotheses show that it could be either protection from UV light to for their symbiotic photosynthetic protists, to hide from predators, or to be less visible to their prey. This is an example of a panther worm, which is in genus Hofstenia, and they are very well known for their dorsal pigmentation that's highly polymorphic. Their class, Nemertodermata, is going to be a more free-living class, and their size is going to range from 1 millimeter to about 1 centimeter. They mostly live in the sand, mud, or gravel, and in genus Maria, they are symbionts in the sea cucumber guts, but it's still unknown if this relationship is mutualistic or parasitic. They do contain a gut that has a well-developed intestinal lumen, but it's still primitive because it only has one opening. And they are mostly colorless, but do contain some yellow and red, as an example back here. And they show, or they reproduce through sexual reproduction, and they have separate sexes. For the phylum, for the final division in phylum Xenocoelomorpha, we have subphylum Xenoturbellidea. This is going to have actually only two species that have been identified so far. It's still a very understudied subphylum, and their lifestyle is going to be in sandy coastlines, in the holes, or offshore mud. They are specialized to eat mollusks and ranges from size to about 1 centimeter to 4 centimeters. They were previously placed in Deuterostoma due to specific sequences in their Hox genes, but after further phylogenetic analysis, they were seen to be more related to the subphylum Acoelomorpha. For sexual reproduction, they are hermaphroditic, and they go through external fertilization, and they also have these horizontal furrows or longitudinal furrows that are going to contain all their sensory cells, and it's believed that this is going to be their form of nervous system, where it's all concentrated in